how to answer all the questions when you're going for a restaurant manager interview. We have all the questions and we give you all the answers. Coming up.
Green salad with French dressing.
Thank you very much.
So here is what I would say if I was at the restaurant manager interview and they asked me the question, tell me something about yourself. Currently, I'm working at Grand Lux Cafe as a head waiter. As you probably already know, Grand Lux is the second biggest restaurant in the United States, and the company provides the top three waiter training programs in the world. Great place to work. I really love that I had a chance to be employed there. And I'm also a trainer. I'm training the new staff in the restaurant. And I'm giving them the first examples of what a great service should be, of course. My responsibility is to greet the guests, take the order, send the order to the kitchen, provide excellent service following the steps of service. One of the things I can mention is that I never had less than 100 points from the secret shopper reports. I have like six reports and only once I have 100, then everything else is 101, 103, 105, 107, which was the biggest score ever done by a waiter at the Grand Lux Cafe at the Venetian. Now, I am also assisting my floor managers with their tasks like scheduling, like time management. Of course, sometimes I had to lead the pre-shift meeting if the manager has some business with a guest. And I do this with pleasure because I really love to learn new things, to take on more challenges. And of course, I'm really passionate about the job. Then our restaurant is a very busy place. As you probably know, the Vegas is 24 hours operation. We always have 300 people waiting online to get into the restaurant. Sometimes we sell $150,000 a day. And it's amazing atmosphere. We have casual dining, a little bit more upscale than the normal casual dining restaurant, but we talk freely with the guests and it's a great team and a great atmosphere with our guests. Before that, I was working at Lombardi's. This was the top Italian restaurant at the Aladdin Hotel. Beautiful small restaurant. I was doing my own station as a head waiter. I was closing the restaurant. That was a great experience because I never before worked in an Italian restaurant and I was learning all the new Italian cuisine and all the new Italian wines. And that gave me a great feeling about the job because this was a family style restaurant and we had the chance to just really talk to our guests, entertain them, make them feel like they are in Italy. So that was a great, great experience for me. Currently, I am looking for new opportunities and new challenges. I want to work for a company that is, a top brand in our business. I want to work for a company that is very well situated for the future to grow, and so I can grow with the company. And of course, I would love to implement my skills and my knowledge into a new environment so I can really prove to me and to my managers that I am an excellent restaurant manager. And that's what the future hopefully holds for me. And I'm a family man. I have a kid. I love to go out, ski, I love to go to the beach. We love to travel with my wife and my kid, and I always read a nice good book, usually some autobiographies or something with financial topics. And that's it, pretty much. And this is all I would say, you know. You structure your answer starting with your current job. You mention the skills, you mention your abilities, you mention your tasks. You know, if you're right now in your current job, not working as a restaurant manager, you mention that you are helping the restaurant managers with their tasks, so those people know that you already have some experience running some of the restaurant manager's tasks, okay? Then you go back to your past and you mention how did you perform at the lesser stations, you know, positions. And then why did you love the job and why did you, you know, perform so well or whatever. And then you go with your desires, with your goals for your future. And you mention all those things that you work for a great company without mentioning their company, actually. You know, you are just saying that you work for a great company, that you want to work for a company that's well established on the market, and it's a position for a growth. And they know already that you're talking about their company because you are applying at their company for the job. So you already answering all those questions. Why do you want to work for us? You know, why did you work at this restaurant for so long? You know, what are your skills? You already gave them all those follow-up questions. You gave them the answers. So once you finish, they basically have nothing else to ask. Now, you can also... This is example when you are not working as a restaurant manager, you want to grow with this new job. But if you are right now, your position is a supervisor or a restaurant manager, you also have to mention some of the achievements that you already have at your current job or past jobs. And for example, if I am a restaurant manager or supervisor, I would say when I joined the team, for the next 3 years, we've been improving guest satisfaction by 15% the first year. Then we improved by 25% the second. And this last year, we improved the guest satisfaction by 20%. And a great, great accomplishment for our team. We are really proud of the job we are doing. You know, so this will be just another 20 seconds to add to the interview. Another thing that you can also add, and it's going to be like another 10 seconds, is my you know, when you're talking about your current job or past job, you can mention like my colleagues, you know, some of my colleagues are wondering, why do I work so hard? Why do I invest so much effort and so much passion about the job? And even yesterday, I had one of my colleagues asking me, Ned, why are you working so hard, man? Why are you pushing so much? And I just told him, you know, because I want that to be my legacy. I want, that's how the people remember me. That's how the people, you know, talk about me. I want people to say, hey, this guy's working really hard. You know, I don't want people to say this guy is lazy. And it's a simple answer. You know, I have passion for the job and that's what I want to do. And that's how I want people to remember me. And this is so, so simple. But at the end of the day, if you don't give them this kind of answer, if you just talk about, hey, I have a family, you know, I have a beautiful kid, we like to travel with my wife, you know, I went to school, I work in this restaurant and this restaurant, you know, but you don't tell them specifics. Details, all those skills that they're looking for, you know, you see the job description, the manager job description, and you know exactly what kind of skills they want the manager, their manager to have, and you talk about the skills and the task that you are performing there, related to the new job, to this job description that they just posted with the job post. And that's how you win over those people. And when you finish answering this first question, basically you leave them without any further questions. A lot of people underestimate the importance of these first questions, tell me about yourself. You know, when they talk personal stuff, you do not talk personal stuff when you're asking this question. You mention, like I said, you know, I'm a family man, I have a kid, I like to travel, I like to read. That's it, pretty much, you know, maybe you like to do sport or something like that, specifics. But you don't talk about, you know, I'm not drinking alcohol, I'm not smoking, I have two kids, they are 8 and 6 years old, my wife is working this and this and so on so. That's great, you know, but this is a conversation for when you're already hired and you sit down with your colleagues and your managers and your owner and you sit down and you talk and you can tell them more about your personal stuff, but not during the interview. During the interview, you concentrate on the things that will help you get the job. And what's going to help you get the job is, while you're talking about yourself, you're answering all the questions that they prepare for you, so they don't have follow-up questions. You know, this is pretty much what it is about this first question. Tell me about yourself. And if you answer this question properly, like I said, you will grab their attention, you will win them, and everything else is going to be just like, all right, we cannot just stop the interview and say, oh man, we hired this guy. We're just going to find some more questions, but he already answered most of our questions. So now we're just going to be like a small talk. All right. And you got the job. All right. So, but of course, we're going to go further with the other questions that you will be asked on a restaurant manager interview, and we'll mention some of the answers. And the second question is like, you work so many years or so many months in this restaurant, what made you stay so long? People want to hire someone that will stay there. You realize they don't want to hire somebody that will quit in 3 months or 3 weeks or even 1 year. They want to hire somebody that will stay there, you know, and take them to the next level. So while you're answering this question, why did you stay so long? You have to give them the answers, you know, why you're gonna stay as long in their own restaurant, you know, and that's what they want to hear. Now, here are some of the answers. You've been constantly challenged with new exciting tasks in that, you know, further your development, you know, and you just give examples. Like, I was just a waiter, but the manager called me and said, hey, do you want me to help? Do you want to help me with the scheduling? And would you like me to leave you the iPod and you set the tables up, you know, the reservations, you place the guest. And that's also a very important part of the manager's job, you know. Or maybe you are in charge for taking the reservations. You know, you don't want to take a reservation at 6 o'clock, 7 tables, and at 6:15, 9 tables. Of course not. You want to spread this in every 10 minutes, every 15 minutes, so you give a chance to your waiters to do a better job and do a better service. And of course, the kitchen also, because the kitchen is going to get stuck if you get 15 tables in a matter of 15 minutes. So you give examples, you know. Now, what else you can say? You can say that you got promoted. You know, I started as a backup waiter, they promoted me to a waiter, and then I was promoted to a head waiter, you know, because I was doing a great job. And you can give them a very short example of the conversation between you and your general manager when he offered you the promotion, for example, you know, something like that. Then you can tell them that you added value to the company and you felt like it's your own enterprise. You know, you felt part of the team and you're very vital part of the team. And this also kept you there. you know, and you have a great loyalty to the company, for example, because this company gave you the chance to start from nothing and become a head waiter or a supervisor, and of course that builds your loyalty to the company, and you feel loyal, and that's why you stay for so many years or whatever. Then of course it's very important the personal part with your co-workers and your management. You know we had a great team there. It was a really friendly atmosphere. It was such a pleasure to go to work every day because I felt like those are my friends. You know, we go to work, we do a great job, we work as a team, and after job, we all together go out and have a beer. You know, this is another way to tell them that you are a team oriented person and you will fit very nicely in their team, and you will create around yourself a community that everybody is friendly with everybody, and you can hang out together, and you can go to work with a pleasure, you know. And of course, you can also mention the money. You know, it was a well-paid job. It was a well-paid job. I was making very good money, and that's important, of course, for me and my family. And those people need to know that you gotta make money if they want to keep you. It doesn't matter how great the job is. Doesn't matter what a team is, and so on. So if this job doesn't bring you the money you need to live well, they have to understand that you're not going to stick around. So it's very nice to tell them that, you know, you were paid well, and that's why you stick around for so long at your previous job or your current job. And this is pretty much everything about this question: what will make you stay so long at this previous or your current job? And now then, of course, it comes the next question. Why then, everything is so great, why are you looking for a new opportunity? This is the next question they're going to ask you, you know. And warning, guys, be careful. Do not say that something went down, or the management changed and the new manager sucks, or the owner changed and the new owner sucks, or whatever. While you're talking about your previous or current experience, you do not say bad things about the company, because guess what? Immediately the red light will start beaming, and they'll say, oh, this guy, when he leaves here, he's gonna start talking the same bad things about us. All right, so you talk about your desire to grow, your desire to you know, to implement what you've learned, your skills and your knowledge in the new environment, and you want to work for a top brand, for example, if they are a top brand. You want to work for a company that is constantly growing, so you can grow with them, you know, if that's the case. You know, you already did your research about the company, you know what company that is, and you can say the things that this company is, and that's why you want to move on, all right? And they will understand that you're talking about their company. You don't mention it by name. You don't tell them, I want to work for you, that's why I want to quit this whole job. No, you say you want to grow, you want to develop, you want to implement your skills and your knowledge, and that's it. But never say nothing negative about your previous experience. Now, another question. Tell me about your time when you have a positive impact on a previous job. And you see, all those questions that they are asking you right now, you already gave them the answers during the first question. Tell me about yourself. You told them about improving the guest satisfaction. So they might even skip this question now. You told them about, you know, why you want to move on, because you're saying, you know, like how you want to grow and blah, 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 blah. They might skip this question too. Why you want to change, you know? So this is the trick. By answering the first question, you actually give them the correct answer about all the follow-up questions. But anyway, let's say they ask you, tell me about your positive impact. And that's what you're going to say. You know, you're going to talk about building the team around you. You're going to talk about how everybody was getting along with everybody, you know, and working as a team. You're going to talk about improving guest satisfaction. You're going to talk about implementing new techniques, like we changed the greeting of the guest, you know. Before that, we were like a casual dining restaurant. Everybody was like, hey, folks, what's up, folks? How you doing? You know, I suggested the idea that we go to a little bit upscale service and everybody greets the guests. For example, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Grand Lux. How are you today? My name is so-and-so and I will be your waiter today. You know, this is very important because if you are applying for a job at a upscale restaurant or a fine dining restaurant, they want to know that you are capable of providing this kind of service. And you can give them many examples and make sure that you like quantify that and you give them the examples that are really from the job, you know, real life examples. Then another question. Tell me about your last team, you know, the team that you led last. You know, what was the dynamic? What was your goal? You know, how did you handle staff conflicts and so on? So if you've been a head waiter, if you've been a supervisor or manager, you deal with those things and they want to know that you can deal with that and you can give them examples again. And I think that's pretty much easy to answer. I already said about building the team, about the dynamics, you know, how everybody worked as a team, everybody was enjoying going to work and then hanging out together and so on. So what was the goal, you know? Did you look for improving sales, like increasing revenue, improving guest satisfaction, improving cost, you know, improving time management and so on. So you can talk about those things. Of course, you have to have, you know, information and knowledge about them, but those are the things that you need to talk, and they're in your job description. You know, the job that they posted, the description that they posted for you know what they're looking for, it's there. You know, time management, cost management, team oriented person, you know, handling guests and complaints and handling conflicts between different colleagues. And you can always give example. If you've been working as a head waiter or supervisor, even just as a waiter, you know that there are a lot of conflicts and you know how to handle, and you can give them, you know, perfect example of handling a conflict between colleagues. Now, those are the questions and those are the answers. Maybe they will ask you about how do you handle guest complaints. You know, this is a big part of your job as a restaurant manager. You know, guest is always right. So tell me about how do you handle guest complaint that you know that they are not right. You know, and of course, you know, provide them the correct answer. I know that the guest is not right, but I'm never going to say the guest that they're wrong. You know, no matter the reason for the complaint, the guest might be wrong, might be right. My goal is to send the guest home knowing that we value their opinion and their business. You know, so we handle guest complaints, you know, following the steps. We apologize. We listen to the guest. We give them solution, you know, reasonable, multiple solution to the problem. And then we act as fast, as quickly as possible to solve the problem, to make the guests happy, so the guests leave the restaurant happy. And that's why, and that's how we keep those guests keep coming. And that's the answer you have to give them. They might ask you about to say something good about another employee on your team. You know, tell me about your best employee on your team. And again, you praise the goals that those people, the skills those people are looking for. You know, you find a perfect example for somebody that is loyal, for somebody that is really following the rules and the steps of service. You know, providing a great service and so on. So, another question is, tell me about your experience recruiting employees. You know, if you are already a restaurant manager, you know, give them the answers. How do you recruit new employees? And then, of course, you have to, you know, tell them that you are looking for quality and not quantity. And when you're saying what kind of quality you're looking for, again, remember the job description that they posted. You know, those are the same quality that you're looking for. And here's a, you know, example. You know, I always check the CV first. For example, what kind of experience, education, you know, how long has been the person staying on the previous job. During the interview, I'm looking for people with common sense, you know, people with critical judgment, you know, that are proactive, you know, and can-do attitude. And at the same time, to build a great team, we need people with integrity, you know. So I'm looking for people with integrity, team players, you know, with the right demeanor. We don't need some, let's copy and I can do everything and I'm the best and all those kind of things, because those kind of people, they break the team. And the team is more important than single player. I don't look for people that boast, you know, me all the time. And at the same time, I'm looking for people that can express themselves very well, you know. Last but not least, I try to hire waiters who are committed, you know, to learn. People that wants to improve. People that wants to learn. Because no matter how much you know, working in a new restaurant, in a new environment, you will need to learn. And if you're not willing to learn, then we're going to have a problem. So I really look for people that are really willing and capable of learning. And for example, if I want to determine if the guy or the girl is such a person, I'm asking a few questions about their previous job. You know, if I ask you a question, are you willing to learn new things? And they say, yeah, of course, I love to learn. Hey, okay, so you work in an Italian restaurant. Tell me something about the Italian wine and the food then. Tell me 5 Italian wines. Tell me 5 Italian wine regions. Tell me the specifics of Ossobuco, for example, or Pappardelle, you know, what it is, and so on and so. And if those guys don't know, although they've been working 3 years in the Italian restaurant and they cannot tell me nothing about wine or the food they're serving, that means that they didn't learn. That means that they are just saying that they want to learn, but actually they are just saying it because they want to get a job, but not really want to learn. And those kind of people, they don't get hired by me. So that's how it is. Another question, possible question is, what do you know about our company? You know, but you already answered this question. You know, when you're talking about how your future plans is to work for this company that is a top brand name, that is well situated and for growth and, you know, constantly growing, so and so, you already told them, you know, that this is the company, you know, they are this kind of company because you're applying for the job there. But of course, you always have to know a lot about the company, about the restaurant you're applying to. You should be able to talk about the history, about their position in the market, about their cuisine. If they have a celebrity chef, you have to mention that. If they have celebrity management, you have to mention that. And all those kind of things. Another question is, what questions do you have for us? And always ask questions, guys. You always ask questions. Doesn't matter if your interview is as a restaurant manager or a waiter or whatever. You should always have one or two questions for them. That would just tell them that you are not desperate for the job. You know, that you're also testing the situation. And you want to put them also on the chair and make sure that you are choosing the right people to work with, because that's also very important. They might have a brand name and a top name in the industry, but this job might be the worst job you ever have. And we've done this in many situations. I personally went to work for the top hotel in Switzerland, top hotel in Switzerland for the last 10 years. Like a really top brand, serving queens and kings and millionaires and billionaires. And it was the worst job I ever had. So that happens too. So make sure you have questions, you know. And if you're a restaurant manager, You can ask questions like, what is the number of the front of the house employee or back of the house employee? You know, what does a busy night look like? You know, what are the covers? How many covers we have on Friday, Saturday night? You know, for example, what is the majority of the guests? Are they locals? Are they tourists? And if they're tourists, from which countries? What is the restaurant culture like? You know, what's going on right now in your team? You know, what is the percentage of your frequent diners? You know, the people that just keep coming and keep coming and keep coming. You know, that's also what is the turnaround in your team also. You know, that's very important, because you don't want to put yourself in a situation where the waiters are quitting every 2 weeks. That's going to be a terrible job, I can promise you right now. And, you know, those are the questions that you have to ask. You can ask about the money too, you know, because money is also important. And like I said, those people need to know that they got to pay you in order for you to give your best effort and to stay there for a long term. All right. And that's it pretty much, guys. This is all about the manager interview questions and answers. If anybody has a comment, anybody has a question, post it in the comment section, and I will be happy to answer to the best of my abilities. Thank you very much. Stay out of trouble. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to check the free online courses at the Waiters Academy. And if you're searching for a job, or maybe you're planning to get a job in the future, a new job, create your profile at the Waiters Network. We are posting new jobs from all over the world every single day. Take care, guys. Thank you very much.